technology, lunar, infrared, capitalism stuff. Oh yeah. And when I was growing up, we had 9 planets. Now it's 8. Where did the other one go? I mean, that is some shit when you can be the government and make a planet disappear. Where did they put it? And who's living there? Here's another fan of the show.
Ron, I think you're right. We're out of tune with the Earth. I've been on a mission to be like the ancient civilizations of South America. When you make a habit of having elaborate sexual rituals with virgins that die at the end, you get a whole new outlook on life. I'm a changed man. I've never felt better. I really like virgins.
Exactly. South America. When I was growing up, people in the South of America spoke English. But that goes to show you, it's about the dark antimatter of money and how the banks and politicians have been corrupted by the Illuminati in a totally different way to the way you imagine. Red alert, people! Banks aren't just about lending you money so you are a slave to the system. They actually enslave you by capturing your DNA at the very moment you open your account and then use that DNA to build a replicant of you that lives in the same house as the one you live in, only in cyberspace. And you have to keep leveling up and buying shit for your character. And that's the truth everyone ignores. There's a virtual me right now, somewhere. And I intend on finding him and killing him.
Ron, I've been wanting to call your show for a while and leave a message. What you said about doppelgangers is true. I have a doppelganger, and we have sex. And it's not remotely creepy or gay. At all.
I wish you would have left her callback number, because I would have warned her. Listen to me. All you twins out there, it's an abomination! You have to kill your twin! In their sleep! Tonight! Right now! Immediately! And for that matter, kill the alien mother that spawned you. She's got a cloning factory in that DNA disaster room. Back to banks and the alternative reality. They not only want you to default, but also sometimes they switch people for their own avatars. So the question becomes, of course, am I me or my own digital reflection? Sometimes when I drink, things get all pixely. It's pretty out there stuff, I know, but... garden wind spinner and blow it out your ass. In Brussels, they have a little boy who pees into a fountain and people drink it. No wonder the euro is such a mess. F***ing pee drinkers. And to think the courts called me creepy? Let's get back to this plot by the banks to use your DNA to build, entirely with your legal permission in documents you signed, a digital slave avatar of you. And that slave version will one day replace you, only it won't have free will at all. You know how they do it? I've said it 1,000 times. Memory. Here's a caller that I use.
Yeah, hello? Yeah, said wait for the beep, but anyway, what you said about memory foam on your last show, that scares the shit out of me. I got one of those memory foam beds. I think it's listening. When I black out, I bang a fat girl. And then she's not there the next day. But I know because there's a big dent there the next morning. That bed remembers. It's downloading my memories and my life every night while I sleep. Ron, I'm scared.
Memory foam. No wonder you're getting such a comfortable night's sleep, America. Wake up! Open your ears! We are going to drag those demon mattresses out into the square of every city and burn them! And those memories and spirits will be set free, like that movie about the Ark of the Covenant. Right, let's play another message we got on the high security, untraceable, truth seeker, podcast caller, messaging system just yesterday. Here, listen to this. It's genius. Real genius. Really makes things clear about the way the dental profession is designed to let people implant heavy metals directly into your brain. Not to make you crazy, but so certain high security government agencies can read your thoughts.
Hi, Ron. Big fan of the show. Real big fan. Look, I want to make things real clear about the way the dental
Somewhere in Blaine County that's developing a nerve toxin so powerful, a single drop could turn the West Coast into a bunch of vapid asswipes who stare at the sun and have forgotten how to read. No, wait. That's the that's my little joke. Stay on your toes, people, because someone is out there and you're probably paying for the privilege. Remember, if you got something for me, Ron Jakowski, then call.
Around the internal organs of a cow. Now, it's very nutritional. It really is a treat. And ancient peoples prized it for its enhanced infertility. And my husband, who rest his soul, he swore by it. Of course, we had five babies because of it. I'm getting a hot flash just thinking about the passion. Please. expired tannin sprays are available wherever tannin sprays are sold while supplies last. Okay, no more of this. Let's get on with the show and on with the cooking. Okay, today we're gonna make ribs. Pickled braised gopher ribs with ranch dressing and a blue cheese dip combo. Slow cook, y'all, till the meat is just falling off the bone. Now, I love me gopher ribs because they're tiny and you're gonna gain such weight when you eat them. It is so good. One woman accused me of sorcery. Can you believe? What an accusation! I mean, really, me? Now, did y'all know that in some parts of the country, you can, in self-defense, shoot anyone you believe is using sorcery on you? Yeah, you gotta stand your ground, honey. Ain't no witch or warlock gonna tell me what to do. Now, speaking of standing your ground, here's a man that doesn't back down from a fight. He's moved from show business to the government like many great men before him. And he's rising up the ranks of politics in San Andreas by giving us policies we can all understand. Now, if we have anything to do with it, he's gonna be our next.
you need, boss. Some wheels? I can bring them around. It's coming at you.
gonna hunt you down.
From you. You don't like TPI? We're a reputable firm. We've got work for you.
here. Ah!